Very good. All right. So welcome to our October 8th age-friendly meeting here. So thank you, everybody. I'm going to go around the room and just we'll do introductions because we have a new face or two at the table. And we, last month, we didn't meet just in person, not remotely. And another new person is remote this time. So I just want to go around. On the table. I'm going to start up on my Zoom screen. Larissa, would you go first, please?
Hi, I'm Larissa Hensler. I am the Community Ambassador for Eastern Area Agency on Aging through the Community Connections Grant Program.
Great. Thank you for joining us. Jonathan?
I'm John Cody, their fire chief of the town of Millinocket.
Very good. Thank you. We'll go here in the tape around the table now. Yeah.
Diane Furukawa, the director of the Millinocket Library.
Subusha, here to present.
Yeah, we'll hear from her in a minute.
Yeah,
Thanks.
that's good. Thank you.
Looking back to Sue. Thanks.
Tom Malcolm, CEO and Life and Health Safety Officer.
Lou Pelletier, town counselor.
Farmers Market Manager.
And I am Peter Jameson. I'm the town manager at Millinocket. I'm going to have this playing in the background.
Yeah, I thought so. So thank you.
You're welcome.
Thanks, Peter. Yeah. And those around the table, no, I'm Jane Danforth. So chair of this meeting. So I sent out an agenda last Tuesday, week prior, so we could get it posted on the website. And first off, I'll just ask if everybody read the minutes from September 10th, and if there's no corrections that are needed for those that were present and read them, I will have them posted.
Fine.
As is, yep. It looks good. All right, so we'll call those good. And so we're gonna get right into, like we said, I called her a special guest presenter, but it was, timing was great because last, maybe it was Monday, Sue, you called me and you said, I have this thing I'm doing now and I'm going to let you talk about it. And no, you know, she wanted to run it by me. And I said, that sounds awesome. How about if we let our age-friendly committee, it's a perfect place to bring this new resource to the table, let folks know and start getting the word out. And so I don't know if I need, you want any more introduction or just tell us, you had quite the story for
no,
me.
No, I can just start by saying, the idea came about due to my concern with individuals in the community that issues had taken place, and I wasn't comfortable with that, with one being on the floor for a few days and the other one had passed, and when they did a welfare check, he had passed on. And thinking about that, it got me enough disturbed that I'm trying to think, well, I can do this. I can put a thing together for call. And so as I sit down, I do the numbers and this and that, I'm thinking that's not going to work. There's no way. So then I started to go online and researching, and I found different available companies that I could go through to help initiate this. And in the process, the one I ended up with is a very reliable company that has been around for since 1954. And the whole point of this is to help people. I want to connect with communities. I want to meet with individuals. I want to make sure that this starts off right with the community support. I can't do this alone. There's no way. And even though I put it on Facebook and I do this and that, and because of the name Maine, I can expand. But primarily, I want this area taken care of, and then we can move on through. I'd like to involve East Millinocket, Medway, and so on. But originally, it's just the concern that we need help here in the Millinocket area and around the surrounding communities. So putting this together, I ended up with Town Care simply because they offer.
So can I just stop for a second?
Sure.
Just back up, because part of our age-friendly work, and we know over the years that we have a need for like this call-in system, somebody that's living alone at home and doesn't have family around, so that somebody can call and check on them, or they can call, because we've tried informally around here to have these, like there's like elder buddies programs or in different things, and there's been other informal ones that haven't sustained themselves. We haven't been able to get volunteer programming. So this type of program that Sue's talking about, it's like you'll speak about it too.
Yeah.
As far as it's it's a program. It isn't a free program. It's something mm-hmm. there's different levels of it that people actually pay into to be involved and with.
That's correct. Yes. And the whole thing is, it's not so much that the elderly will be signing up into this. It would be the their children will be looking into this and say, geez, mom or geez, dad, look at this. This sounds really good. Maybe we can get this going for you. They don't have to do anything. All they have to do is go on and sign up. I've been through the process. It's easy to get involved with it, to sign on to the program. And there'll be three types of call. Some people want to hear a voice. They're lonely. Or if they're from out of state, the parents want a phone call with something personal. I would myself. And that starts off at $59.95, and they accommodate you. They call you up. They do a care check. They have several names involved that should you not be there when they call, they will call the individuals on the list. And if that doesn't happen and they can't reach anybody, then they will have numbers that they can call to make sure that they get appropriate resources to the individuals. What I know with this for myself, to get a call and to be able to talk, they can see if you're doing okay. They can hear the voice. They'll know, or the person can say, I'm not feeling well today. Can you get a hold of, you know, so-and-so for me? Because ideally, you can call somebody 5 days a week. You care for them. You do everything you can. There's 2 days that you don't contact them. Anything can happen with that, you know? I mean, it's not that people don't care enough. It's just, it's very difficult to meet that need on a daily basis. So this is where this can come in. Then you have your automated calls where they would end up calling you whatever time of day you want. They're very accommodating. If you want a wake-up call, they'll give you a wake-up call. If you want a reminder for your medications, they can do that as well. If you have a doctor's appointment, whatever, they can help customize the plan they have. And they, with doing the monitor check-in call, they would call you. You would click one. Yes, that means, yes, I'm home and everything is good. Again, if they can't get through, the scenario would be the same where they get in touch with your family. And if they're not available, then they would contact the appropriate people as well. So that can be helpful if people just don't want to be bothered with talking. They just want somebody to know they're okay. And the price for that one, I believe, is $19.95 a month. The last call type of call is a monitored check-in call. And that would be where you would call them. You could be anywhere. You would just call them because maybe you don't want to be bothered with a phone call, or you might not be home at that certain time of day. You can call them for $14.95 a month. You let them know, yes, I'm here, everything is good, or you just call in, and I think it's a one that you press to let them know you've made the call. And should you not call in within a certain period of time, again, they would get in touch with you and the same protocol would follow. If no one is available, they would get somebody to you regardless. And with this, so the reason I went with TownCare, there were two other companies, but TownCare had all of what I was looking for and they were less expensive. And I feel, you know, that's an important thing because financially people are just really can't afford a lot of things. And I know Jane had talked about different ideas on how to help individuals that may not have the money. If I had it, I'd give it to them personally. I mean, you know, I really would. But I've really done my homework on this. The company, again, is reliable. When I started with this, I called the individual and he got back to me. He said, I'd like to speak with you so we're all on the same page. The others weren't that accommodating. This guy here, Carl, has been phenomenal. And every time I call, he gets right back or he emails me. We set this up in a matter of days. That's how efficient we both were. So, I mean, it's ready to go. I have it on Facebook. Facebook has given me a little bit of a problem with my links, but still it's on there. You know, I mean, it's visible. And I hope to What I'd like to do is go to the police department, make sure that you have some information, the doctor's offices, give them the flyer with this, with my card, and I'm easy to contact. I mean, that wouldn't be an issue. And somebody mentioned go to the churches, you know, and there's just a variety of places where I can go, and I wouldn't bother them. I would just leave this there and say, if you need anything, give me a call. You know, we can either talk or, you know, text or whatever, but I certainly would be available for people. I don't have a phone number on there because I really don't want to start getting messages 24/7 when I'm at work. And the whole point of this is you come to me and we'll get you where you need to go with the company. If you have questions before you want to contact, text me, I can give you a call, you know, so we can work it out in that fashion.
So can you just remind me, do you live in Millinocket? Do you work for the city, the state, or?
I work for Design Lab.
Oh, for Design Lab.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Yes, I okay. do. Sorry. And they've been so helpful with oh, all okay. of this. Okay. Yeah.
They really so have. You're just doing this as a side hustle? That
you oh, no. It just, honestly, when I heard of different stories, it really, okay. really affected me.
Okay.
And I'm thinking, geez, something, you know, this isn't right. And I know my mom had issues one time when she had fallen, and it was horrible. And we were able to get somebody there. I mean, and we knew it happened, but it was still horrible to yep. see her on the floor. You know, I won't ever forget that. So this here is extremely important. And again, I can't do it alone. So if there's any way that I can outreach more, or that you have ideas, don't hesitate. Because, I mean, I've been open, like with John's had ideas, Michaela, Jess, and I've implemented them because I want it to be a success. This isn't about me. You know, this is about the communities, as far as I'm concerned. So
when I was talking to Sue and just trying to get clarification on that, so she's not the person that's going to be on the other end of the call. She's helping people get set up with this town,
yes.
with their programming.
Yes.
You've created your own website for mm-hmm. people to learn about this. So maybe you want to talk about Senior Check-In Maine. That's your website that you create.
Yes, yeah, so Senior Check-In Maine is where I have a lot of information on there, not just about the service, but resources and links. And what I'm looking for is, if you know of an organization that would like to have their links within my website, let me know. I've talked with Jane. Thrive is in there. And that makes it easy. Let's say if some of the elderly do have a computer at home, or the families do, they can go in there and they can see the resources that are available. The more resources we have, the better it is, because they can get on there and the town, publicize events. Maybe some of them would like to go to events, you know, or participate more. But primarily, there's the resource link, and then there's just an informational link. And I also have an About Me page. I have the page pretty much like this, explaining town care itself. And I was trying to, it's a very basic, simple, easy functioning website. And you can certainly get from one place to the other with that. And when I started to put this together, I went through WordPress and I developed the website myself. It was quite a learning curve from when I used to do websites. My goodness, it was just, oh my gosh. But within 2 months, this all came together. This is how intense I was about the whole thing, especially with winter coming. And it would be a good thing. So I don't know if there's more I can touch on, but the website itself is quite informational. And if I could put the library on there for them to contact. And what I can do is I can make sure that you view it, approve it, or send me something that you would like to go as a description. If there's something you would like to submit in, anyone, you know, just see what we can do to start getting that page to expand with resources for the area. And I'm not duplicating Thrive.
No, I know that.
You know, no, but no. That's important, because yeah. I know people in the area sometimes, if you duplicate, and I understand that, they're sensitive. So I just want to make sure that yeah, I'm not trying to compete or do anything other than to help. And Jane has been phenomenal with it and whatnot. So if... I don't know if I've covered it enough.
We'll see if others have questions.
Where are they based out of?
Pennsylvania. And they actually do the United States. And when I talked with him, I wanted to make sure they weren't spam. So when I talked with him, he gave me the whole rundown on the company from 1954, how they've developed and how they've come about to provide various services. So of course I went on research and whatnot, and their page has the same amount of information on it. I went to the Better Business. I checked different resources and they were real. This is not a scam. You have to be so careful today, you know. And out of all of them, I've been treated quite nicely with this company. And he said, boy, Maine is an aging community. I said, yes, it is. And I said, this is why we're doing this. And he said, you know, just I'm the only one in Maine that is presenting this. And what it is like what Jane said. I found the company. It would be hard for people to know where they are. Can you trust them? What do they do? And so therefore, setting up the website, and I had to have a website in order to send them to the company. When you leave me, and let's say you choose to sign up, you'll go to their page, and right away, so that people feel comfortable and they know that it's valid, they have my senior Maine check-in right up on top. So it validates that it's coming from me to them, you know. So, I mean, they've done very, very good with that. And I was impressed, you know, and I just finished talking with Carl again with some of my concerns. He answered them all, got right back to me. So, but yes, I am the middle person with this. And it's legit and it's real. So,
so Larissa, you have a question. Go ahead.
Yeah, so I'm looking at the website now. So when someone fills in, like the contact us, they want to send you a message. Does it go to you or where does that contact?
It goes to me, yes. Okay. Yeah, and I will know when someone sends it. It's through the my email address, seniorcheckinmaine@google. That's where it will go. So I will receive it immediately. Whenever anyone signs up, I will be notified as well. So I will be able to make sure that, you know, if things were to happen that people weren't happy with their service, they can contact me. I've got it right in there. You let me know and we will take care of this. If it means I have to drop the company, I will drop the company, you know, but they seem to be reliable. And I will let them, first of all, kind of see if they can work it out, because sometimes you just don't know. But if it happens several times, I certainly would take action on it.
So when you get the contacts and then you refer to who do you refer to go help these people?
In the website, you'll see several places where it says sign up, and on the town care page as well, it'll say, and at the top of the website it says sign up on the upper right part of it.
Got it.
And on the About Me page, I believe there's some, but I check in where the page for check-in is, there is a sign up right up there. There's a sign up button below. I mean, you know, it's very well laid out. So you can just check on that and it'll get you right where you need to go. And I can probably be a little bit more explicit in explaining that. But pretty much as you're reading through, it'll say, if you want more information, go to the page, that the town care page. You get into the town care page. Geez, if you want to set up and if you want to sign up for this, it's right there as well where you can sign up. I mean, it's quite transparent as far as that goes. And I may be able to make it easier, but in going through that, it's you can get to where you want to go quite easily.
And this is statewide or this is just for Northern Maine?
Well, I'm starting here because it's easier. But as it expands, I have the opportunity to do it statewide. That's why he laughed. He said, you do know you have the whole state of Maine. No one else is doing this. And I said, well, isn't that amazing?
Yes.
You know, but we'll start here first.
The service from town care is national. Is that because they're based in Pennsylvania?
They're based in Pennsylvania.
So anyone could sign up in Maine on their
yes.
own. Your service of like helping people sign up is local, just
to
clarify.
Yes. Okay. And the good point about this as well is that you come through me, you're going to learn everything about it. You're going to know it's real. You're going to know it's trustworthy. And that's the whole point. And that's what they want, is they want people to set up websites. They want that third, that in person in between to send them from here to them. Mm-hmm. And their work is pretty much done when that takes place. So initially, I'm just the little vehicle that gets you from point A to B.
Can I ask another clarifying question?
Yes.
Are you meeting with people to help them sign up or kind of emailing them links? I'm just thinking about a lot of folks here who have maybe the digital skills to even like fill out that email form or you know, use the website to do that. Yeah, I just wanted to clarify what service you're meeting with them or what.
Well, not really.
No.
A lot, if the family calls me
yeah.
and they want help, certainly I'll help them. But it's not something that I want to get out there and sell that I'll help them
okay.
Do all of this and do all of that because I want a life. I'm old.
Yeah, here. Oh, that's totally
you know, yeah.
Spreading the word.
Yeah, I'm spreading the word. You know, at my age, I could probably use the service here. But seriously, yes, I'd like to keep it as simple as possible, but I would be right there to help anyone through the process if they called me or whatever, that wouldn't be a problem at all. But basically you go from me to them. And if I need to make things a little bit more clearer, let me know. Mm-hmm. And the same with you, Larissa, let me know if there's things that you need clarified. I don't mind at all. So, and Jonathan, do you have any remarks at all or? He's froze.
Well,
no, that's just his picture.
It's his picture, so he's probably in his office.
Okay.
He's busy.
Okay.
Yeah, he might come back on.
I have a couple questions. Is it possible to talk to any current clients of theirs to, you know, like references?
Well, they keep things confidential. They don't like to give out clients. Matter of fact, I'm live. I'm not able to give any of the names out. You can go on their website, and I know that they've listed several individuals
giving testimonials.
Like yeah, giving testimonials. And I may even be able to, I'll ask them if I can take their testimonials and put it on my page. But but yes, they do have several testimonials and people seem to be, from what I understand, quite pleased with them. And being around since 1954, that's what impressed me more than anything.
Yeah.
Yes.
In terms of the price, do you know, is it monthly? Is it annual? Can people cancel on 30 days notice?
You can cancel whenever you want.
Okay.
That is not
What's the initial startup cost?
It would just be
1 month? Or?
Yeah, depending what plan you want, they would just start with that monthly plan.
Okay. They go month to month. They're okay with going monthly.
Yes, yeah. But no, you can cancel anytime you want. They don't hold you to a contract or anything. So.
Because I can see there's one plan at $14.95, $19.95, up to $59.95.
Yes.
So what you had shared here, there were like three different plans.
Three different plans. And like they said, they would accommodate. And if you needed, sometimes when they were saying when people are discharged from the hospital and they may need monitoring for 2 weeks, people coming in and out. And if the caretaker would like to have a call coming in daily for them to answer the phone and say, geez, we're good for a 2 week period, they would do that. If you're in college, parents are worried, you can sign up your college students on that as well, particularly with the way things are today.
Yeah.
I mean, you never know, you know, so, but there's a variety of ways that they can help, in order to set up whatever you need. They were saying we would accommodate you, you know, so,
and like you said, if they can't reach, if there's no response to that person, then there's the, like, I mean, you're familiar with that, right, Tom? There's like three other names, family members' names.
Yeah.
They're going to go down through the list to like to get a hold of them.
Yes.
You know, so-and-so's hasn't responded. Mm-hmm. Will you go check like that? Well, do a well check. And then finally we'll go to EMS or whatever.
Yes. And that number would be provided by the family. This is who we want you to call if we can't, you know, if we're not available.
Yeah.
You don't so, back. But they seem to have covered a lot. And I've pretty much taken everything from their company and their website and put it right here. And of course, as I go along, I'm sure I'm going to find out different things I want to add or, you know, to make it interesting. So
I'm wondering, Jane, if there's any kind of grant we could get to help subsidize people for this, because I mean, $59 is going to be out of range for a lot of people.
That's the high end.
Yeah.
And the other one. And
even 19, you know, I mean, maybe we could explore that idea too.
And that's what Jane had talked about when we were talking. She was excited about perhaps finding grants for the community. And you know, maybe something can be done. I'm not sure, but if you wanted to have some kind of a gathering or whatever to earn money specifically to apply for this or whatnot, GoFundMe would be tacky, I feel. you know, it's just, what do you think, Tom? His eyes just squinted out there.
Thinking about how we could do that, yet not tie it to age friendly.
And so we've got some things.
But yeah, we could do something through age friendly to build up maybe a pool of money.
Okay.
To have sort of and offer scholarships or assistance, or that way we don't step on your business.
Oh, and that, to me, honestly, you can step all you want. You know, as long as
I'm. This is wonderful. This is what I've been trying to do for years. I mean, we did it a little bit at the fire station, but not the way that it should be done. This is down the way. This is the way it should be. Because a lot of people, somebody ends up calling 911 for them, and they come and they're fallen, or they may not just not be home. Well, you're going to get billed for that. Every time they come, they're going to get a bill.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so with this, it's going to go down the chain before it ever gets to
that
calling the police or the ambulance. I think it's wonderful. I think it's
good. I'm glad to hear that.
It's a U.S. company.
I didn't know.
So.
Yep.
They got to talk English.
Sorry.
Some guy in India. Yeah.
That's right. It makes a difference.
Yeah. It does.
Super necessary. Yep. I mean, there is definitely a financial barrier for some, but it's something that their kids want to pay for, for their parents or something like that. Mm-hmm. Or, you know, I think we can brainstorm about creative funding solutions as well.
I can bake.
I can, yeah.
And then certainly promote it to our health desk here. I want to talk to you more about that afterwards. And we have the resource wall and that kind of thing. But I did just want to clarify, like, if someone doesn't have the skills to send the email, is there just a general phone number for the town care company that they could call to get signed up? Because I think that might be a barrier for some people.
I can provide the town care number.
Okay.
I
know that rather they go through you, but for some people, that might be an extra step for them.
But
Okay.
I think that might be a good addition to, like, that there would be a phone call.
Yes, because I did ask them. I said, what happens when if I'm going to sign up for something, and the sign up form is there, and I'm where the website is. If you think I'm going to go through that without snooping around,
mm-hmm.
Okay, I want to know about them. I want to check the website out, and I get nosy and all of that concerned. It's my money, so I said, so what are we going to do about that, Carl? And so he came up with a response that, you know, he found a way around it and whatnot. And because I was sleeping that night, and I wake up and I'm going, I could lose half of my business, you know, doing this. If they just go for me and they're nosy like me, you know. So we've worked it up that when they go to sign up with them or whatnot, there will be a way that they will know it's me. So that was worked out. And this is where I say they're so helpful.
Okay.
You know, I mean, he understood fine. And he said, yes, and he said, generally they don't. I said, yeah, I know, but I would be the exception probably, but I want to know.
Yeah.
You know,
I don't understand what you mean about you would lose half your business.
Say what?
I don't understand what you mean by you would lose half your business.
Well, let's say that if I didn't set it up with them to ask them, you know, gee, if they all go through your contact form, every time they go through their contact form, it wouldn't go through me. So I would not make any kind of a small income on that. Okay. When you sign up through me, I get a certain percentage.
Oh, okay.
So if half of them, and I'm going to try to set it up on my website with an app that I have outbound links, so I know when they go to them, and I know how many are going.
Okay.
Just for all intent and purposes. That's what I mean by that.
Okay. I didn't realize that you were getting commission. Okay.
So, but most definitely, yes. It's just... And I'm not saying that, you know, I'm not going to lose some, that slip through the cracks, but when you're talking a major amount, that would bother me because I've made an investment in the one that's marketing, you know.
You could do a free Google number just for this, if you wanted to, a dedicated number that would just handle this. It's a thought.
Yeah. No, I'll think about it, because that's what I've been doing. I'll just say no. And then, and then the next day I'll go in, Michaela. Yeah, you were right, Michaela. We'll do this. And we've done that so many times. Or John, I'm not going to do that. Well, then it was the thing with the picture. Your picture should be on it. If you think my picture is going in there, think again. The picture is in there.
Yeah.
We put it in this morning.
That branding is so that there's a local, a local face, a local name.
And they said, make sure you put, because on Facebook, until I put Sue Bouchard, resident of Millinocket, there weren't many hits on that at all. The minute I put Sue Bouchard on there, and I'm thinking, I'm going to die. Everybody, my name is out there. I'm so private. This is like really difficult.
Sure.
So anyway, the picture went on this morning and I said, they're okay. You know, but I understand what they all mean, because they need to know they can trust. They need to see a face. And I knew that. That's why I started to get more personal. That's why I put the personal story in there. And whatnot. So, like I said, I've had a lot of help and a lot of suggestions from people. I really have. And I listen. So, know that.
Okay. Are there any, I'm just looking at the time and just, are there any other questions for Sue? Everybody,
she's done all the research. She's done everything.
Yeah.
So, you're all happy then, huh?
Get the thumbs up from us.
Yeah. Larissa, are you content? Are you satisfied?
From Eastern Europe. Yes, and I can always reach out if I have questions. Thank you.
Yes, you can. Okay. Yes.
And I know there'll be some follow-up with Diana through the library, and we'll continue to I know you put some stuff out on Facebook, and I'll share it through we'll share it.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah,
you've done well with that. And I've picked up several followers already. I was surprised. But Facebook will not allow me to put my link in there for the website. They have stopped me from, and then they said, oh, you made a bad mistake here. I hit the wrong number. Excuse me. I hit the wrong button. Yeah. And they come after me right away. You're done for 3 days. And I thought, oh, my gosh. So then when they come back, it was like I finally was able to put my email address in there. But I still can't get my link in there for the website. And I've contacted them. Well, you've got blockers up. No, I do not. You know, I've taken them all down. So yesterday I must have sent them 4 messages. They're gonna know me for sure. But I really want this resolved here. So I can be persistent. But did I answer all of your questions?
I think so, yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
Very good. Will we have any? All right.
Yeah.
And I know we need to move on. So.
Well, and I'll get your email address. We'll just add you to the age-friendly group. And when you can join us for meetings in the future.
That would not be a bad thing. So, that way I can keep updated.
Keep in contact. So. Figure out how to.
I know you.
Yeah. But you need to stay to the rest of it.
So I'll catch up.
Okay. All right. Yeah, we'll see. Oh, look at the pressure you just put on me to type those minutes. But you stay. You don't.
Yes, I'm not going to. I made a point to want to be here today.
You don't have to leave the meeting. And I don't know if Jonathan can come on screen now or not. I just want to talk about the grant opportunity. And I know, Larissa, you had sent out a reminder through Eastern Area. I know that the Lifelong Maine Community Connections Grant. We spoke about it a little bit at the last meeting, and Barbara had a great idea because she had a great experience with our local fire department.
If we could get a grant to subsidize putting really dual carbon monoxide fire alarms for people, and then people installing could do a quick check and see if there's anything that needs immediate attention, and would kind of serve two purposes. But for sure, getting people the new alarms for the winter would be great.
So I followed up with the chief after our meeting and I've talked with him. And so we're going to upgrade.
He's back.
So we're going to put in an application around that. To purchase like 100 of them. They're like $60 a piece and get the batteries and stuff. So he has some in stock, because there's no program right now where we have just some at the ready. Red Cross has them available, but you have to go on. Online and apply. But you want to speak to it, Jonathan?
Yeah, so when you guys reached out to me, or I should say Jane reached out to me, that'd be a great idea, because right now we currently don't have a program in the firehouse. If it's a critical need, we go out and buy one. And if not, we reach out to the Red Cross with their resources that they have to you know, set up a time to go and do the install of those smoke alarms. So thinking, you know, in the future, if you know, if this opportunity works, you know, we would have them on site here at the fire station. Not everyone would probably need a new one. A lot of times it's just a matter of us going to replace a battery. And also we could do a home safety survey at the same time while we're there. We just can't go in and do a home safety survey unless the owner, the residents, you know, ask for us to do one during that time. So I think it's a great program. It's a need because we get phone calls here often, or we're on emergency calls and people are asking, you know, about smoke alarms or batteries, you know. So we carry batteries on hand. That's easy. But to carry, you know, a smoke alarm with the cost of them today, especially combination smoke alarm carbon monoxide, it's close to $60, which is pretty expensive. So, you know, we don't have them on hand here at the fire station because of that reason. And then reaching out, you know, to the Red Cross, it's not always that easy getting them from them either now. So, and usually it's a delay. So of them trying to find somebody to come and put them in. So, you know, I've waited up to a week and a half, there 2 weeks before, you know, to get them. We've been very lucky. The ones that we needed to put in, we were able to work next door with the True Valley and get those addressed to work there right away. So
very good. So I'm Roy Smith. I've got most of the application ready, and I've got the okay from Peter and Amber.
Great.
And next on the town, we'll meet the deadline.
Because we had this. We had it for 25 years.
I remember.
And there was no town money in it. Mm-hmm. But if we're going to do this, I think it needs to be an age-friendly project.
Yeah.
Because if we don't, same thing's going to happen that happened when I had the program. We're going to get somebody that decides they don't want it anymore. All it takes is one counselor to get somebody, get like two or three of them going. We lost it. Well, you can remember when they took it away.
As far as don't want the program?
Yeah, they told me to discontinue the program. We weren't doing it anymore. And we never took any. That was all raised money. There was no town money involved in that. Hmm. So we're going to do this. We need to do it so that we protect. So that, you know, down the road, they don't decide that they don't want this anymore. This is an age-friendly program through the fire department.
But, yeah, you know, it has to be written
in the other thing department that we need to watch with this is apartment buildings. Under state law, we don't put smoke detectors in apartment buildings because they're required by state law to provide them.
Yeah.
And if they don't, all they need to do is report it. That's a code violation. So, and that, I think this is great. We're signed up. We're actually at a Red Cross distribution center, Milwaukee Fire Department is.
Nice.
And we had cases of them. And then a few years back, they came and got the ones we had because they said they were going to revamp stuff. Well, what they ended up doing is Maine Red Cross went away, and now it's New England Red Cross. In fact, I'm meeting with them on October 21st to talk about that whole program and what happened with them. So I think this is great. Like John said, you got to have them. When somebody calls, you can't be waiting a week to get them.
And I appreciate the fact that once they're in there, that you can do that safety check and look around. And I was going to have a little bit extra money put in there, perhaps for a grant. We talked about like a grab bars or anti-slip rugs, or I've admitted John had some thoughts about that. If you go in there, identify a need. So I'm going to write some of that in there. So yeah, you can ask for up to $10,000. I won't quite go up there, but we'll get up there close and make it appealing. So very good. That's exciting. I'll do that. So go ahead. Any other member updates?
I have a quick update. Farmers Market. Next Saturday will be our final one if there is not a rain date. We were rained out this past Saturday. And I just had some thoughts about perhaps coming up with some incentives to get more farmer involvement. And again, it might involve writing a grant of some kind, but a gas stipend for people who have to come drive an hour, maybe waiving the fee for the first season that they come, or even for 2 years. We're really having trouble getting farmer participation, and I'm going to be working on that this winter. But Also, the Maine Farmers Market Association is doing a Zoom course over the next few months, which I applied for, about market management. It's free, and I applied. I should be able to get into it. So they may have some ideas as well about that. So I just wondered what people's thoughts were about helping incentives for farmer involvement. And also, if we could maybe come up with a certificate for volunteers. I'd like to do something for Russ Rogers. He's been really so helpful with lots of things. Even if it's just a little paper certificate of some kind that we could print, you know, because he puts out the wayfaring signs, and he's been very faithful in coming. Mm-hmm. And also for next year, I would like to get slightly larger wayfaring signs. Amber showed me at the beginning of the summer some that had like a black frame and were, I thought, were larger. The ones we have are kind of small, and I was just wondering, they're not very expensive. Slightly larger wayfaring signs would be nice, a little more visible from the road. But any thoughts from anybody about incentives for farmers?
Can you remind me what the fee is
currently? It's $40 for the whole summer, which is super low. Yeah. And only $10 if they can only come one Saturday, because some people go to Lincoln. But for the Amish farmers, they have to pay a truck driver to bring them, and then it's gas an hour to here and an hour back, and $40, you know. So just to be really accommodating, to be welcoming, I'm going to do a lot more research on who is within an hour radius. And we do have Chiron once a month, which is great. They were not able to come. They didn't come for the rain date, but they also said they were done with Senior Farm Share. So I'm thinking maybe our last date should be the date before Trails End next year, because it's just really dribbling off participation in October.
Yeah, and next weekend is the fly-in cruise-in, so I bet the numbers are really
right. Good. Right. So, but the vendors who come do quite well, actually. They have the through hikers coming from the hostel, and then people waiting to pick up the hikers need to have something to do. And I've met some really interesting people. Oh, we had also talked about a table of some kind with a sign-in book and maybe a place to take a picture with, you know, like a mural of Katahdin in the background, and maybe having that on the town website, celebrating the through hikers. Because some people don't have any family to pick them up, and they're kind of bedraggled, and they say, I'm going back this afternoon. And, you know, I say, congratulations.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah. It's very, very informal. So yeah. I'd like maybe to formalize that a little bit might be nice.
Yeah. So I'm wondering if we should just have a meet, like we had met before, just to like
a separate
yeah. little meeting, yeah. and just specifically talk yeah. about that, mm-hmm. to yeah. think about next year.
I just wanted to let people know that over the winter, I will be working on these various ideas and things. And, you know, it's an uphill thing, but the people who come really like it, and they love the Senior Farm Share. And the woman who at Trails End, who was doing the goat milk soap and lotions, had a beautiful booth with a tent and two tables and all kinds of good stuff. And she said she would come to our market, but she couldn't come last week because of the rain. And I think she said she's flexible about coming to the last one, but she did say, you know, it takes a few years, Barbara, don't be discouraged, you know. So she was super nice. And if we could get a couple of vendors like that, that would be great. Oh, also more children's activities, mm-hmm. you know, because if people knew, there might not be produce, but there would be face painting and some children's activities. And so there's really still a lot more to do, but
there is.
Yeah. Yeah, but it's fun. I love doing it. And the vendors, like, they like it. The ones who come, they do well. So, and it's nice to have something there for the people. You see them coming out of the hostel kind of dazed and looking around. And when they see us, their eyes light up.
Yeah. Up in the park.
Yeah.
No, I appreciate all the work that you put in and the thought that you put in and the research fun. And yeah. stuff. And so we'll have to.
Yeah.
I've talked to two or three of them. Of the food vendors, the farmers.
Yeah.
And they're not coming down there. They're gonna stay on the hill. And that's what they're doing on Saturdays. They're on
yeah.
the hill.
Yeah.
The traffic is much, you know,
greater.
Don't get a lot of traffic down there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
You know, and I've been thinking about this for a couple of weeks. Do we look at talking to the collaborative or whoever it is that owns the corner lot?
Oh, yeah, the Heritage Park. Yeah.
About setting up in there.
Titan Tourism Partnership.
I don't know if they'd be open to that.
That was my first thought.
I've been trying to think of a way that we could draw people because a lot of them aren't turning down. You know, we get the
hospital. I know. People, but right. A lot of
don't get a lot of people that are going through.
Yeah.
And I think that may, I don't know.
Say that they're going to be doing infrastructure and things there at some point.
Yeah. I know they're going to at some point. But
yeah. A lot of people have, and I tell them, well, we have insurance right now at Veterans Park. We have the porta potty. We have the hostel. But I'm open to doing it wherever, you know.
I was just going to say, if people can do this money quite easily, it could be an entire setup, you know. They're always looking at that space, like wondering what is there. I think it'd be worth a try, even if it was just for an opening weekend or something. It would even give the local and not quite as local people the visual to go, oh, that's what that's about. Something along those lines. Not completely up relocate you, but I do agree with that.
Yeah.
Very much.
I thought to be considered. See what's going on there. Very good. Thank you.
And it's gonna be a long-term solution, obviously.
Right.
No, you know what they, you know, eventually they're gonna do something with that space, but
I was thinking we're ahead in the minutes last time. We talked about the community garden really quickly. And then I just heard this week somebody's watermelon, another melon, some was taken from there. So thought I got through the season and the community garden without any incident, but somebody's was taken.
Maybe we need to buy a couple cameras for them. So,
thinking about that too. Like Kale wasn't taken, the person that was had a great Kale wasn't taken, another stuff, but a watermelon and another
one. Watermelon.
Sign that just said
surveillance cameras or something like that. So that's any other updates or age related topics of discussion we need to cover today?
Oh, I do have a ton of wonderful pictures. Should I send them to Amber or to you? You know, I don't want them to get lost by the wayside.
I know, I was run from the farmer's market. Yeah. I mean, I can put some in a...
I was going to ask
her. Maybe both of us, okay. Just like so that she has some, because of they're downtown in the park, and just like, if you have some, send it.
Some of them are kind of... repetitive from week to week, but there's some, like there was a couple from Japan and, you know, a few interesting things like that. So. And I'm going to ask if she wants a little update for the current newsletter, like a wrap up kind of for
that. I think something was put out about as far as a deadline. Are you aware of the deadlines?
24th, I believe it is. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Good.
Okay. I have a couple of updates. I just want to mention a meeting that's happening this Friday, the 11th, from 11 to 1 here in this room or on Zoom. It's with the Genesis Fund. This is kind of on behalf of Tracy Perry from the Collaborative, so that's why I don't know all the details off the top of my head. But they are going to come and talk about the work that they do around feasibility studies, financial projections, and project planning. I think primarily for housing related projects. So I mean they're a company and they're coming to share what their services are and how that might be a helpful group to work with regarding housing planning. Do you know more about this? I will forward the information to the age friendly list, but I know it's not directly age friendly, but you know, we have talked about housing shortages and getting creative in that sense. So I wanted to share that. Tracy asked me to share that. And then I think I've mentioned this before, but I just want to reiterate, we are working on some themed resource lists here. We used to have one giant one and then it was like 50 pages long. So we're kind of breaking it up into different sections and could use your input. We have one that's actually now a childcare related resource list, which I don't think we could have even made like 5 years ago, which is great. Different options. We have one. It's not so much a resource list, but we're trying to inventory all the places in the region where you can have a meeting, if they're accessible, what the amenities are, who the contact person is. So if you have leads, I might be sending out some of these links for people to review. And then we have sort of the basic needs one, so around food and heating and things like that. So, yeah, if you're excited about resource lists and you want to geek out, make sure, you know, we're cross-referencing correctly, let me know. And a piece of that, the reason that we're kind of revamping that and doing that in a new way, did I mention the systems mapping thing last time?
No, I don't. Just keep talking
okay,
about it.
I'm gonna keep talking.
I think so. Yeah.
People need to hear things 7 times, right?
Yeah, that's right.
So we are working with a fellow from the University of Southern right now to map the resources in our region. And we're definitely gonna be working with what Thrive has already compiled and other groups have already compiled. But we really want to understand what's here, what are the gaps, what are the barriers that people are encountering when they're trying to access basic needs, resources in particular. I mean, by basic needs, that would include like mental health and healthcare and transportation, all those sorts of the domains of livability. So I may be reaching out to you, or it might be Nicole, to try to get your take on what you're seeing and the resources that you're aware of. And I'm really hopeful that we can use this fellow to help us better understand that and advocate for some of the gaps that we're seeing. So,
very good. Yeah. And as far as your other resource lists, I want to make sure they get linked onto the Thrive Penobscot website too. I've been on my website looking. There's a bunch of stuff that need to come down that are outdated that I just realized I fallen short on. So
probably a lot of websites we could get on.
Yeah, I know, right? Yeah.
I think for a while
this is like,
that's right.
For a while we were trying to build like the perfect website, and now we're just like, okay, these are all some nice looking Google Docs that anyone can click into. But that way, you know, someone tells us an update, we can just update it right away. And we want to make them easily accessible on our website. But if you want to link them anywhere else when they're done, we'll be happy to share that information. Sorry.
Yeah.
And it's really based on like the questions that we get all the time here. So
great. All right. I'm looking to see if there's anything else. Not do we look ahead at November? It's the November 12th. We were looking to keep our meeting schedule.
And I was just wondering if there's been any action around that link for the heating assistance application. Has anybody asked for help with that? Or
I would have to ask John. I thought he was going to be at this, but last time we found out that you can apply for heat yourself online, and Barbara helped us figure that out. And so John, our resource navigator here, he will meet with people and help them do the application if they weren't able to get an appointment with Penquist.
Because they're booked out till February.
So we've just been kind of informally spreading the word about that so far, so he could do a few test runs.
Okay.
But tell people he's happy to help them with that. But they need to bring all of the necessary paperwork. So if they call, he can tell them exactly what they need to bring.
Great that he's doing that.
I was asking
about the 12th. If we stayed with the second Tuesday of the month, does that work for folks, or do we go to the 19th for any reason? Does it go to Veterans Day? Does that work?
Right.
Go ahead with the 12th. So we'll set the next meeting date. Is the room available?
Yeah.
Okay.
Have
oh, nice. Thank you.
And at one point you had talked about maybe we would change our name to something that was more representative. Are we just going to leave it age friendly for the?
We can put that on the agenda for next time.
Oh, okay.
We want.
Yeah. It's not a big issue for me, but I sort of agree with you. But I don't know what to do about it.
Some other communities have gone with the livability, like livable. Yeah. Yeah, instead of age friendly Millinocket, it's been
even all ages or something.
And speaking of that, it just made me, I know at the last meeting I said I was getting ready to go to the conference and represent Millinocket. So I was unable to go. I had been sick the week before and still wasn't up to par to go to Augusta. So I had to cancel. I did not go to that convention. And so sadly, just had to say, I missed out on that, but I needed to get better. Wasn't able to go, but Yeah, so noted, Barbara, because we have said that before. Perhaps I know some other communities have changed their name from the age friendly to something else. So we can discuss that, the merits of that. Good with that. Well, thank you. So look at this. It's at 3 o'clock. We can officially end our meeting and we'll see if the manager comes back on, stops record for us. Yeah, there's a smiley face.
I've been listening.
All right. Thank you, everyone.
Have a great day, guys.
All right.
Take care.